In the 1940s and 50s, we had a rush of reports of eerie goings-on. It started with combat pilots in World War II. They reported red glowing globes following their fighters and bombers. They called them Foo Fighters, not to be confused with these guys. In 1947, it was reported, and later denied, that the Army had secured the remains of a downed spacecraft along with its passengers. Not to be confused with this guy.
We of the other planets have long accepted this principle.
It became a craze. UFOs, or flying saucers, as they were beginning to be called, flitted all over the skies from Narbonne, Indiana to Hong Kong, China. And as with any craze, anybody who ever saw one or was offered a ride in one was automatically assigned to the loony bin. Well, now in 2022, over a half century later, all those loony bin occupants are emerging into the cold light of day, even if they are being released reluctantly. To find out why, we need to go back 18 years to examine what is called the 2004 USS Nimitz Tic Tac incident. The Nimitz, a U.S. nuclear-powered aircraft carrier, and its escorts were operating 100 kilometers off the coast of San Diego. Modern radar and sensors on the ships picked up returns, objects, that were first detected at 80,000 feet and then would drop down to 20,000 feet and linger for several minutes. Now, there's not many modern aircraft that operate at 80,000 feet, and certainly none that can cover the dive from 80,000 feet to 20,000 in less than a second, because that comes out to about 23,000 miles an hour. The equipment picked up direction-changing lateral movement that would turn any living thing into a thin light of paste. Or maybe they were unmanned drones. To simply lay off such a sighting to less than stellar equipment quality or electronic clutter doesn't say much for classified and state-of-the-art electronics that have the responsibility of protecting us from foreign attack. On an afternoon in September of 2004, the objects were at 20,000 feet, while a group of F-18 Navy fighters were airborne on a training mission. They were ordered to intercept the objects and observe. They did. The naval aviator pilots and weapons officers in the planes visually sighted the objects and photographed them with regular and infrared cameras.
There's a little thing. It's rotating. My gosh. They're all going against the wind. The wind's 120 knots to the west. Oh, thank you.
We have tackled many strange stories on 60 Minutes, but perhaps none like this. It's the story of the U.S. government's grudging acknowledgement of unidentified aerial phenomena, UAP, more commonly known as UFOs. What do you think when you see something like this?
This is a difficult one to explain. You have rotation, you have high altitudes, you have propulsion, right? I don't know what it is.
Now, it's hard to fool modern sensory equipment and the qualified eyes of observers specifically trained and skilled to make these observations. How do you explain this? Are we being visited by aliens from a faraway galaxy? Well, people have been watching these things since the beginning of recorded history. Are they here now? Here's something else hard to explain. Shortly after the 2004 Tic Tac incident, and they're so named because the observers reported the strange objects resemble large white Tic Tacs, the U.S. Patent Office registered patents that could possibly be capable of enabling such speed and maneuvers. The patents were offered by a naval intelligence officer. One patent, a craft using an inertial mass reduction device, describes a process that would enable us to engineer the fabric of our reality at the most fundamental level. And if you don't believe it, just Google this patent number, US 10144532B2. Reverse engineering? You tell me. You tell me, because I'm not going to put myself into the loony bin with those other characters. NASA is now investigating UAPs, unidentified aerial phenomena. I trust those guys. As long as they don't wear funny hats. And as Sherlock Holmes so often stated,
when you have eliminated the impossible, whatever remains, however improbable, must be the truth.
Just saying.